Hello guys, and this is Scott here, and it's been quite a long time, but I've got another historic video for you today. And in this one I thought we'd have a look at the very severe winter of 1981-82. This winter saw two very severe months in December and January, and I thought since we're approaching the winter now, why don't we have a look at this event? Now, before we get started, I'd just like to say that many of the charts that you see in these videos come from the historical archive at wetterzentral.de. They have a historical archive going back to January the 1st of 1871. So like I always say, if you want to suggest a historic video, you can pick anything from the start of 1871. And many of the facts and figures that you hear in this video come from the fantastic data set run by Professor Trevor Harley. He has his own website, and that's where many of these facts come from. And as with all of these historic videos, none of these would be possible without Professor Harley. So let's jump into the video now, and we're going to start off on the 23rd of November 1981. And to be honest, there's no real reason to start on this, except there was a very interesting weather event on this day. You can see generally the pattern's not all that interesting, apart from maybe a bit of a hint of blocking around Greenland. You know, we've got heights building a little bit over Greenland, which I suppose could be a bit of an indication of what's to come later on in the winter. But on the 23rd of November, we actually brought a very active cold front across the country, and very remarkably, it actually produced 105 small tornadoes across the country during a 5 hour and 15 minute period in the afternoon. And this is actually the biggest tornado outbreak on record in the UK, and in fact the rest of Europe, in fact. So quite a remarkable day there on the 23rd of November. But it doesn't really speak volumes of the cold spell that's coming up. It sort of was just an unrelated event that I've thrown in there. But as we go through the rest of November, so into the 25th and the 27th of November, you can see generally the pattern generally remains what you'd expect it to be honest. We have areas of low pressure coming in off the Atlantic, and of course the Azores High to the south, which is generally keeping the pattern fairly mild at this stage. And that's really where we finish off November. You know, we try to get a little bit of a northerly there on the 29th, before that's flattened off on the 30th of November. And that takes us into the start of December 1981. And December 1981 was a very severe month. It has a central inland temperature of 0.3 degrees, but actually these opening days were quite mild. In fact, this is just to point out, this is actually the severest December of 1981. Of course, this has been bettered by 2010 now, but in the 20th century, this was the coldest December of that century, and as I said, it didn't quite get going straight away. So there we are on the 1st of December, and generally we have high pressure trying to throw up a bit of a ridge there. And as we go through the 2nd and into the 3rd of December, we actually build a bit of a blocking feature around the country. Now, this wasn't really overly cold at the time. In fact, we were bringing quite mild air over the top of that high. So actually through the 4th and into the 5th of December, we actually have temperatures up into the mid-teens across quite a wide part of the country. But that certainly doesn't last long, because as you can see there on the 5th, the winds are starting to go round into the northwest. And as we go through into the 6th of December 1981, we're now starting to bring down some very cold air from the north. You can see that area of high pressure is pulling out into the mid-Atlantic, and we're setting in a very cold trough there over Scandinavia. So that's plunging some really cold air over Scandinavia, and that's actually starting to come our way. And that carries on into the 7th and the 8th of December. You can see there we really open the floodgates there to that bitterly cold Arctic air on the 8th of December 1981. And on this day, there was actually some very heavy snow in London. This was the first snowfall of the winter for London, and it actually caused quite a bit of trouble with the transport networks. But this was, as I say, this was the winter really setting in. It was really setting in at this stage after that very mild start to December. And it carries on really as we go through the 9th and into the 10th. In fact, things get more and more severe through the 10th of December. And there was actually quite a lot of freezing fog around on the 10th, which produced some quite interesting sights of that rime frost that you get on a lot of surfaces. It's often associated with freezing fog, and there was a lot of this around on that day. But that actually allows the temperatures to fall really low, because as we go through into the 11th of December, we actually record a minus 13 Celsius minimum at Glasgow, and actually on this same day there was 26 centimetres of lying snow at London Heathrow Airport. But at the moment that really wasn't it, because as we go through into the sorry, those are the upper air temperatures there on the 11th of December. Actually, not really that interesting. You might think, given these very low temperatures we had, we'd be getting some very severe upper air temperatures, but they actually were quite tame, to be fair. It was really a lot of the time we really got quite lucky in this month. It just shows that as you build up these cold upper air temperatures, you can get some very deep surface cold developing, even when the air off the surface is actually quite in isn't really all that remarkable. And that's what we saw in this month. But as I said, the surface cold gets really intense as we go through this middle part of December. As in fact, for three consecutive nights between the 11th and the 12th to the 14th of December, minus 20 Celsius, minus 20 Celsius or lower is recorded in Shrobury in Shropshire. In fact, we have for these 3 nights, we record minus 22.6 degrees, minus 25.1 degrees, and minus 22.0. So some really phenomenally cold weather. And it wasn't just those cold nights, because as we go through into the 13th of December, you can see we've got a really deep area of low pressure developing out in the Atlantic. And as we go through the 13th and into the 14th of December, this brings a huge, huge blizzard across the country. There was a major blizzard in the southwest. In fact, we record 95 miles an hour wind, mile an hour winds, and in fact, there was snow drifts in London up to 4 feet deep from this. So really, a truly bitterly, bitterly cold winter snow event there. And in fact, if that wasn't enough, the very deep area of low pressure actually brought a very severe storm surge up the Bristol Channel. So, not only was there, deep drifting snow and gales to worry about, but there was also quite a lot of flooding in Bristol due to this. So really a phenomenal winter blizzard there on the 13th and 14th of December 1981. And actually, as we just go through the month, it just carries on really. So through the 15th and into the 16th of December, we keep low pressure generally to the south of the UK. So we're bringing snow bands in from the south, which is again, it's just adding to those snow totals. And again, we're getting bitterly, bitterly cold nights under this. Into the 17th and the 18th of December 1981. And again, generally, like I said about the upper air temperatures, the pattern isn't all that remarkable. It was a bit of an oddball December 1981. If you've seen a lot of my other cold winter videos, you'll often note that there's often tons of blocking to the north of the country. And in fact, we have got a small amount of that over Greenland. But really, it's nothing, overly dramatic. We've actually got quite a strong polar vortex there, as you can see by those deep blue and purple colours. But it was just right, really, so we really got quite lucky in this month. As I say, it's quite an unusual month to actually get such severe colding, but nonetheless, we did pull it off. And it pretty much stays cold, really, as we carry on. And again, and as we go into the 19th of December, we bring another very severe blizzard in. But unfortunately, this one has some pretty unfortunate consequences, because we actually get the Penley lifeboat disaster on this day, which was where a lifeboat actually capsized off the coast of Cornwall due to some very, very severe winds. You know, 80, 90 mile an hour gusts caused this boat to capsize, and unfortunately, all 16 people on board were killed. So, you know, for us weather enthusiasts, you know, this was a very interesting month, but you know, interesting weather does come at a cost, and that's something that we all have to remember, unfortunately. And that was the case on the 19th of December 1981. And that blizzard actually carries on as we go into the 20th of December. So again, look how tight those isobars are. So again, we're bringing gale force winds across the country into the 21st and the 22nd of December. You know, again, we're setting up low pressure around the country. So we have snow showers piling in across the country, again, adding to those snow depths into the 23rd and into Christmas Eve 1981. Again, we have low pressure skirting by to the south into Christmas days, but it was quite a benign Christmas, this, you know, not a true white Christmas, but generally a lot of lying snow. So certainly, you know, you could call it a white Christmas, but not an official one by what the Met Office say. But then as we go into Boxing Day, this is where we start to get a moderation now, as this area of low pressure in the Atlantic starts to force its way in. And as you can see, we're bringing up quite a far-fetched southwesterly there. So as we go through Boxing Day and into the 27th, we do start to bring some milder air now into the country. So we do get a bit of a thaw at the end of December, but not much of one, I might add. Winds try to go a bit easterly again there on the 28th, but on the 29th. But generally, you know, the consensus is now we're a little bit milder. And that takes us into New Year's Eve. So, you know, we finish off the phenomenal December of 1981 on quite a mild note there. But was that the end of the cold? In fact, no, it wasn't. Because as you can see there, we've actually still got hints of blocking over Greenland. And as we go into January 1982, we get another very severe freezing this month. Now, the central England temperature for January 1982 comes out at 2.6 degrees, which, you know, doesn't sound overly severe actually, but this was due to a mild start and end cancelling out somewhat that big freeze in the middle of the month. So, you know, the CET not quite as indicative of what this month actually had to offer. But nonetheless, it did produce a very, very severe cold spell. So we start off there on the 1st of January, and as I said, again, we've got, you know, the hints of the northern blocking around Greenland, and low pressure is out in the Atlantic. But again, you can see it is on quite a southerly track there, and you can see the jet stream's running quite far south. So, you know, it's mild at this stage, but you know, not overly mild. And really, that goes through the 2nd and into the 3rd of January. So we get a little bit of a mild push there on the 3rd. But again, notice that the low pressure in the Atlantic is actually quite far to the south. So again, you know, just little hints that a very severe cold spell could return later on in the month. And as we go into the 4th and into the 5th of January, we actually get some very severe rainfall, actually, because between the 5th and the 8th of January 1982, we actually get 100 millimetres of rain across parts of Yorkshire. But the problem was, the ground was actually still frozen from that very severe December. So actually this caused some catastrophic flooding across parts of Yorkshire. In fact, the River Ouse that runs through York actually suffered a pretty catastrophic flood on this in this period. So, you know, again, just, you know, more trouble being caused by this winter. But again, as we go through into the 6th, this is where the cold starts to set in now, because as you can see, you know, the Greenland blocking starting to open the floodgates to a northeasterly wind there, and those low pressures are being pushed to the south. And as we go through into the 7th, again, now we're starting to get high pressure setting up around the country, and now we're starting to record some very severe temperatures. In fact, overnight 7th and into the 8th of January 1982, we actually record a temperature of minus 23 Celsius at Braemar, and minus 26.8 Celsius, you know, at Grand Town on Spey. So a very, very severe frost there, you know, a phenomenally severe frost by UK standards. But that wasn't it actually, because on the 8th you can see we've got low pressure also coming in off the Atlantic, and overnight 8th and into the 9th we get a severe blizzard across the Midlands and Wales this time, and this brings an easterly gale and 30 to 50 centimetres of snow with drifts of up to 20 feet, can you believe? So 20 feet, that's absolutely absurd for a snow amount in the UK. But nonetheless, we did actually get it off this blizzard in January 1982. It was an absolutely phenomenal blizzard, and I actually have a picture of it which will come up in a second. But as we got later on into the night, you know, skies cleared behind that blizzard, and we actually then on the morning of the 10th of January as well under that ridge, we record minus 27.2 degrees at Braemar, which makes it the equal coldest temperature on record in the UK. Interestingly, all three winter months in the UK actually have minus 27.2 as the record, and this was the time that it was set for January. So an absolutely tremendously cold spell of weather, you know, absolutely unprecedented. You know, we hadn't seen much like this before. But with all those deep snow fields and the high pressure around the country, you know, there's really no surprise why this happened. And those are the upper air temperatures there on the 10th of January. And, you know, no surprise why it's so cold. We've got the minus 10 Celsius isotherm across the country, and actually some very deep cold at the surface as well. So, you know, unsurprisingly, we're recording such low temperatures. And there was no end to the freeze, really, because as we went into the 11th of January, again, we keep that blocking to the north of the country. But again, you know, not, you know, again, you'd look at that pattern and think it's not overly stark how big the blocking is there, but it was just enough. And as I said, I think there was a lot of luck in this as well, that we got such severe weather under this. That's the picture I was showing you. This was taken on the 11th of January. I'm not sure where this is actually, but, you know, some big snow drifts there. What looks like a man is trying to, you know, shovel it out of the way. You know, an absolutely phenomenal weather event there that took place in December and January. And again, it carries on into the 12th as we keep that ridge of high pressure around the country. And in fact, there was some very severe fog in this period, some very severe spells of freezing fog again. And actually, this lasts through the 12th and into the 13th of January 1982 under that area of high pressure. And in fact, under fog, Benson in Oxfordshire actually records a maximum temperature of minus 13 Celsius. You know, just minus 13. So it's absolutely unprecedentedly cold, you know. Just, again, something that we've, you know, not really had much experience of before. that we got in December and January of 81, 82. But besides all that now, the freeze was slowly starting to come to its end, because as you can see, as we go into the 14th of January, you can see now that area of high pressure is starting to pull away into Eastern Europe, and now we're starting to set up low pressure in the North Atlantic. So on the 14th of January, we did get one final cold day before, by the 15th of January, the Atlantic finally broke through and we brought milder weather in. You know, so this explains the central inland temperature, why it was 2.6 and not a much colder one. And really though, that was the 16th and into the 17th of January. You know, that was really the end of the winter, can you believe? But besides this mild spell, actually, snow lay for quite a big portion of January. In fact, Balmoral had continuous snow in this winter from the 4th of December to the 28th of January. So even with this mild air, it took so long to melt all of this heavy snow that had fell in December and January that it actually lasted until the end of the month, can you believe? So, you know, again, it does speak volumes as to how severe this weather event was. But as I said, that was really the end of the winter, because actually as we go through into February 1982, I'll just show a couple charts here. It was generally quite a zonal month, actually. It has a central inland temperature of 4.8. So it was actually quite a disappointing end to this winter, to be honest. And there on the there's the chart for the 1st, you know, and the 10th of February, you can see. So again, it's just a very mild month, to be honest. And again for the 22nd. But yeah, I hope if you were alive in 1981, I hope actually this has brought back some memories for you. You know, I thought it's just a little bit of an interesting video just to do to whet the appetite of what's coming, of what could potentially come up for the winter, of course. The weather in this country always has different plans for us. But yeah, so if you've enjoyed this this historic video, please give me a like and a share, and be sure to leave a comment with your thoughts and your suggestions. But that'll do for this time. So thanks for watching this historic video, guys, and I'll see you soon.